At this point, I'd like all of you to close your eyes. Yes, close your eyes. And I want you to notice if you feel anything on your skin. The itch of fabric, the texture of cloth, the softness of your shirt. You can open your eyes now. You probably notice the feeling of your clothes on your skin when you put them on in the morning. But over the course of the day, you likely learn to ignore them because you have far more important things to focus on, like grad slam talks. But the thing is, you have 86 billion neurons to help you with this feat of learning. What you've just done is a form of learning called habituation. Habituation is a decrease in response after repeated stimulation. And in your case, the repeated stimulation was a rubbing of fabric against your skin. Now, you have a brain to help you, but I'm interested in how even a single cell is capable of the same type of learning without a brain. So now let me introduce the charismatic Stentor coeruleus. Stentor is a single-celled organism also capable of habituation. We can find them in local ponds, and I sometimes collect them from Golden Gate Park. Now, Stentor, when they get a tap in the pond, they contract from this extended state in the first image to a contracted state in the second image. This is an escape response from predators. However, when they get repeatedly tapped, such as from harmless ripples in the pond, they actually learn to ignore it, and they remain in their extended form. My research focuses on the following question. How does a cell even learn without a brain? To answer this question, I use a device we built in the lab to tap the cells over and over, probably much to their annoyance, and I analyze their contraction behaviors. What I found is that each cell undergoes a single stark switch from the naive state, in which they're mostly contracting, to a learned state, in which they're mostly extended. Basically, a eureka moment for each single cell. I also explored the molecules involved in this process by treating these cells with drugs. And I found that Stentor might learn using proteins that are similar to human short-term memory. So by studying habituation at the level of a single cell, we can learn more about the origins of intelligence across different life forms. We can even get a more fundamental cellular understanding of human disorders of habituation, like OCD and ADHD. So the next time you put on your clothes in the morning and learn to ignore them over the course of the day, I hope you give a nod to Stentor for showing us you don't even need a brain to be smart.